following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
This is the War Machine Rhino, the last ever ECW World Heavyweight Champion, and you're listening to Damage 365 Radio. Keep listening, or you'll get gored in half.
Esposito's Pizza and Pasta. Check us out at one of our fine locations, 930 Route 34 in Mattawan, New Jersey, or 233 East Main Street in Manasquan, New Jersey. From pizza and salads to pasta and buffalo wings, we have something to suit every member of your family. Whether you're seeking to take out, delivery, or you just want to dine in, let us do the dishes, as we would be more than happy to take care of your next meal. Our courteous and friendly restaurant staff is here to meet and exceed all your expectations. We promise an enjoyable experience each and every time we serve you. Try our award-winning Sesame Crust Pizza, our recent winner at the Las Vegas Pizza Open. Visit us online at sesameseedpizza.com for store hours, menus, and phone numbers to one of our great locations. Esposito's Pizza and Pasta, so close to eating at Mom's, but without all the yelling.
Hey, this is Bruce Pritchard, and you are listening to Damage 365 Radio. But I need you to know something. Just because I love you doesn't mean I like you.
Hey, wrestling promoters and booking agents. You know where you can get inexpensive prints of your hired talent? Right here at Fast Copy Printing Center, located in the Pearl of the Bayshore. That's right, whether you need 8x10s, 11x14s, posters, long format, or even weatherproof signs, we can do it all. We also can create promotional items for your business, such as pens, business cards, drink koozies, banners, or just a coffee mug. Stop on down to Fast Copy Printing Center, 81 Broad Street in Keyport, New Jersey, or call us at 732-739-4646. No job is too big and satisfaction is guaranteed. Tell them Damage 365 sent you.
This is Lanny Poffo, formerly the genius full of glory and renown. You are listening to Damage 365 Radio.
The Funkenstein Wrestling Superstore, selling wrestling memorabilia from all around the world, including WWE, Impact, ROH, Japan, Mexico, and the Indies. They sell action figures, lucha masks, t-shirts, trading cards, magazines, DVDs, autographs, collectibles, vintage video games, and more. Stop in to get tickets for local independent wrestling such as UWA Elite, CZW, and Synergy Wrestling. Located indoors at the world-famous Englishtown Flea Market, Blue Building, Booths 45 through 48, 90 Wilson Avenue in Manalapan Township, New Jersey. Open every Saturday and Sunday from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. all year round. Visit them at Facebook at facebook.com/Funkenstein Inc. New Jersey's largest wrestling store is the Funkenstein Wrestling Superstore. Tell them Damage 365 sent ya.
Attention, attention everyone. This is Allie, and you're listening to Damage 365 Radio.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
This is Outlander Zicky Dice, and you're listening to the All Night Long Podcast.
All night long.
It's the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. With the Enforcer.
I believe they're called Enforcers, Gordon.
I sell women's shoes.
And the Stallion.
Stallion, baby!
I am not what you would call a handsome man.
I'll kick you in the nuts and you'll smile at me and like it.
All night long.
Oh, and we're back with another edition of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. We are your hosts. He is a Stallion. I'm the Enforcer. And we are on location today. It's 2:10 p.m. on a Saturday. It's weird. It feels off. We never podcast on a Saturday. But even more so, NXT TakeOver is never on a Sunday. Joe, has that thrown you for a loop this week?
A little bit. Yeah, I keep forgetting kind of what day and what time it's on. So it's actually a Sunday night show this week. No accompanying WWE main roster show with it this weekend. It's on its own in Portland. So Sunday night, 7 p.m., I believe, is TakeOver Portland. 7 p.m. on the East Coast, as they say.
You feel like that's a good move for them? What do you think? You think Saturday was the money or Sunday a nice change of pace?
I was used to the Saturday shows, I guess, but... Yeah, I don't really have any issue with it being on Sunday. I think Sunday is probably the best day for wrestling pay-per-views. At least that's what I feel. So, yeah, it'll be interesting to see. I mean, this card has six matches on it, so maybe it'll go a little bit longer than a standard takeover. Usually the takeovers are like 2.5 hours. So it's possible that this maybe goes a little bit longer. It's got six matches on a Sunday, so we'll see, I guess.
Six matches on a Sunday sounds like an emo band. Joe, have you given any thought to... following in the footsteps of Zicky Dice and starting a band?
I can play a mean ukulele.
Are you saying this because you actually watched SmackDown last night and you saw Sami Zayn's ukulele?
Absolutely not. Nope, I had no idea that was the case.
I was going to say, you probably had no idea that even happened, did you?
No. Happy accident.
Happy accident. He says, you know who I feel like could play a great ukulele too? Kyle O'Reilly.
Yeah, I think he's very musically talented just overall, right? Like, he no limitation on what different musical instruments that he can play.
No, he's a man of a thousand talents. I will say, when he first started doing his guitar solo on the way to the ring, there was a meme that came out with a gif of him playing the guitar, and somebody said, I'm fairly certain Kyle O'Reilly has never picked up a guitar in his life. And I thought it was the funniest thing. And listen, before we get into the NXT TakeOver predictions, I want everybody to know, if you are a fan of NXT, if you're a fan of somebody like a Keith Lee, if you're a fan of somebody like a Rhea Ripley or Tommaso Ciampa, and you're from New York or the tri-state metro area, and you're like, man, I just want to – they never come to New York. I just want to meet these guys. Joe, do we have a surprise for you? La Boom, Queens, New York, February 29th, Leap Day this year. Evolve will be having a doubleheader with Shine first and then Evolve. And if you're looking to get tickets for the show, here's what you have to do. It's a very, very simple process, and your friends here at the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast have once again hooked you up. So you go to wwnlive.com. You go through all the e-ticks, whatever it might be. When you go pick the tickets you want, you click the seating chart, sit wherever you want to sit, and then at checkout, you enter the code TAPOUT, TAPOUT, and you get 10% off, not just one ticket, Joe, not just two, your entire purchase, man. Where can you find a deal like that, pal?
Only here, courtesy of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast and Evolve and Shine Wrestling.
Yeah, we seriously appreciate them partnering up with us and just kind of doing right by us. And we're trying to do right by them, get as many people to check out the show as possible. Listen, Evolve is always a packed show. You know, whenever you and I go to the shows, it always sells out. I feel like more people starting to take, take heed of Shine. The main event for the Shine show is Ivelisse, the current Shine Women's Champion, taking on friend of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast, Lindsay Snow. You're going to see a lot of talent in Shine now that you're going to be seeing in 6 months, 12 months, 18 months in either AEW or NXT, WWE. For example, Aja Pereira just got signed to NXT as a referee. I mean, you know, we've seen Chris Statlander from Shine go on to AEW. There's so much cool talent out there, and it's such a good price for the show. Check it out. Get a chance to meet all the athletes. Man, it's going to be a really good time. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and, you know, folks, for whatever people may say about the NXT relationship with Evolve, you know, whether it's positive or negative, you know, it's pretty cool, I think, either way to, you know, get to go to some of these local, you know, indie type shows and see superstars of that level, like, you know, the Keith Lees, Tommaso Ciampa, Rhea Ripley, who will be coming out to the Evolve show, as you mentioned, on the 29th. So, you know, you can purchase tickets to the show through us, as you mentioned, with the promo code TAPOUT, and get an opportunity to see some great wrestling and meet some of those superstars as well.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We'll have much more on that. Hopefully have some talent from those shows in the coming weeks. And we have another special show planned on Monday. I don't want to give it away, but we're just firing off content here at the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast. And if you want to follow us anywhere, like I've said before, at All Night Long WP, everywhere you could find social media. For example, we got some love from Bandito this week. I mean, it's Joe, we're just we're really rolling here at the show, and it feels good.
I'm glad. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, that's the best I can give you today. I'm sorry.
I appreciate your positivity, man. I know you're trying to watch the XFL, so let's get to the card without any further ado.
All right, man, let's do it. Six matches Sunday night, NXT from Portland. Let's start with the NXT North American Championship. So Keith Lee is now the NXT North American Champion, having beaten Roderick Strong a few weeks ago on NXT television. He is being challenged by Dominik Dijakovic. These two have had several matches in NXT already, and prior to that on the independent scene. Pretty much any time that these two get together in the ring, it's always an exciting match. What is your prediction for this one, Mikey? We may have lost Mikey. It's possible. So maybe I'll go first with my prediction. I'm going to go with Keith Lee. In this one, I think it's too soon for him to drop the title, but I think the match will be very good, of course, as it usually is. Dijakovic has kind of been treading water a little bit lately, but I think that Keith Lee is going to retain the North American title on this show and keep his momentum rolling, as they say.
Joe, am I back, and can you hear me?
I can hear you now, buddy. Glad to have you back.
I appreciate that, man. Just, you know, I got the gimmick internet as a thing. But listen, I want to put a little wager on the line here. How about the loser of this little pickoff here buys the winner Dunkin' Donuts at the Evolve and Shine show?
I'm in. I'm in for that. So I don't know if you caught, if you caught my pick, but I went with Keith Lee for the first match here.
I did, actually. It was weird. I could hear everything. I just couldn't speak, which might be good because I'm stupid. Yeah, I'm going to go with Keith Lee, too. I think this is a showcase to get for people to really get wowed by Keith Lee and what he could do with Donovan Dijak. Kovic, I almost said Dijak. And Dominic Donovan. Oh, dude, just correct. You know what? Correct me in post, Joe. Keith Lee wins, and it's like I said, it's a showcase for him. It should be a great match. I think Meltzer called their match at PWG a couple of years ago the greatest North American match he's ever seen or something ridiculous. They'll get the time. Keith Lee will shine, but he will not lose the North American title yet.
All right. So let's next go to a street fight. It is Dakota Kai versus Tegan Nox. The back history here goes back to Takeover War Games from late last year, where Dakota Kai was a replacement on the NXT team, or the that particular NXT women's team, and turned on her friend Tegan Nox at that point. They met once on NXT TV a few weeks back, and Tegan Nox got the victory there. So I'm going to go with Dakota Kai to get the win here. I think coming off of a heel turn that she had back at TakeOver War Games, I think that she needs a win here, and this feud should continue. So I'm going to go with Dakota Kai.
Yep, I'm 100% with you on this one. I think she's the she's got the rocket strapped to her, if you will. I think the new look, eerily reminiscent of the Bayley heel turn, is it not? You turn heel and you have to darken your hair. I feel like kind of like a guy, you know, if you have bleach blonde hair, you turn heel, it's got to go black, man. So, no, I'm with you 100%. There should be no surprises here so far. I think it's kind of a paint-by-numbers takeover card up to this point.
So next, I think we should go to the NXT Tag Team Championships. It is the Undisputed Era, Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly, defending against the Broserweights of Matt Riddle and Pete Dunne. These guys won the Dusty Classic this